So Don Charlo. Okay, so that wasn't the guy. Overall. Oh, whoa, he's low. All right, guys, Otaku Guy here. Welcome back to UFC 4. And Dana White has basically just given us our report card based off of our last five fights. And honestly, I agree with this. Normal CPU defensive awareness, grappling aggression. I am not ready for this. I mean, I don't feel like the tutorials, goodness. I don't feel like the tutorials were in-depth enough to, like, for me to immediately be this good at the game. And then I definitely need to have, like, an entire career mode path before I even attempt this. So, moderate it is. It's a challenge, but it's not too easy, not too hard. Perfect for this. So let's do this. Ooh, a contract earned. What's this? $5,000 show, $5,000 if I win. Alright. Sweet. Is that per show and per win? Is that how that works? Or is it specifically just for a fight? Oh, wow. Career home is where you receive fight offers and contracts from the WFA or UFC. You can also review your contract bonuses, fight history rankings, and greatest of all time status. All right, Fighter Evolution. This is what I'm interested in. This seems like a skill tree kind of thing. Hey, 30,000. That's not bad. Earned in sparring to improve fighter attributes or unlock new perks. The cost of some attributes will rise as your longevity decreases and some of your attributes will decay over time. Okay. Okay, that makes sense. So I want to learn as soon as possible because, you know, it's hard to teach an old dog new tricks. Attributes lost due to injury must be recovered using evolution points. Dang, this sounds tough. All right. So I got moves. This is move evolution. Every time you land a strike, submission, takedown, or transition, you gain move evolutions for that move package. You can view the current move evolution of all your fighters' moves. All right. And we got perks. Okay. Roundhouse and switch kicks are faster and more accurate. Do I just get to customize it now? Alright. To your feet, able to get up from the ground more easily. I mean, that'd be very useful. Especially if I don't want to be on the ground. Alright, I think I'm going to go with to your feet. Just so I can get off the ground, which is a place I'm not, like, super safe in. I just wanted to check everything before I, you know, tried it. So can I just... Goodness, I'm not trying to do all that. Yeah, there we go. Become a UFC fighter, become a UFC ranked fighter, become a UFC champion. Alright. Wait, can I upgrade him here? Just by... Okay, no. So then, those are just for the different perks. Alright. Makes sense. Alright, so the money, I assume, is for some training stuff, but the stars is what upgrades me. Improves ability to... Okay. Health. Cardio. Stamina. Super important. Yeah, let's get all these to three. There we go. That way my body is really, there's ability to recover health and endure health events. Yeah. Having a solid body is more important. Hit moving target. Countering, improves countering advantage after a successful block. Also contributes to overall arm health. That seems very useful. I am a knockout puncher. Or, I'm more of a kicker, honestly. Powerful all kicks and knees. All right. I think this is good. Yeah, I think punch speed, and kick power are good things to invest in. Especially for me specifically, the kick power, just because I like landing those big kicks and I like landing them fast. And then I'd rather have speed over power when it comes to my punches because of my jab. That way, I can pop them out faster and stop any other advances and counter. So. Looks like the only thing I can do right now is just accept a fight offer. This is a fight offer. You can unlock information about your opponent using the watch tape option in training camp. When available, you can accept or decline fight offers. Declining a fight offer could create a future rivalry, but could also negatively impact future contracts and bonuses. You'll also be sitting out longer between fights, potentially leading to others passing you in the rankings. Well, I can't have that. So, it's not like the other games where I had a list of people to fight. This is who I'm getting, and I get to fight them. Okay. Hype, very low. Max camp length, 4 weeks. Starting fitness is moderate. Alright. Okay. He's only like an inch taller than me. That's fine. Let's do this. Wait, what? Scheduled training camp. Gym fee, 35% of total fight payout. What? Let's just go with that. Because I don't know how it works in this game. I'm just going to go with the default setting. Okay. Sparring lets you practice with training partners specializing in different aspects of MMA. You can also invite a fighter to your training camp to learn new moves or watch tape to scout your upcoming opponent. Okay. Hype gives you access to promotions and sponsorships, which can earn cash and increase popularity. You can also improve your connections with other fighters to reduce the cost of learning new moves. Alright, this is very in-depth. This is a lot different. I like this. Lots to remember, though. All training camp actions cost weekly points. You have 100 points to spend each week. Injuries suffered during training camp will take away weekly points. I can't get injured, which makes sense, yeah. Alright. Invite training partners to learn their moves. Watch tape and some information about your opponent. I'm not too concerned about what my opponent's going to be doing. Let's just do some sparring. Sparring allows you to train different aspects of MMA. Sparring sessions improve your fitness, provide opportunities to evolve your fighter's moves, and earn evolution points. Okay, all moves related to the sparring style are listed here. Every time you attempt a move in sparring, invite a fighter, or fights, you gain move evolution for that move. Once enough move evolution is gained, the move will automatically upgrade and earn you bonus evolution points. Each sparring session has a challenge. Complete the challenge, will earn you evolution points, and increase the difficulty of your next sparring session. If you do not have the move required for a challenge, you can refresh the challenges or go to invite a fighter to learn the move. Makes sense? Yeah, right now I just want to be the best me that I can be. I don't need anyone's moves just at the moment. Muay Thai. Okay. Practice your clinch and kickboxing against a Muay Thai training partner. Gain move evolution points for kicks and clinch strikes. Okay. I don't need to do any of that. I mean, it would be good for me to increase these stats, but I want to do what I'm best at first. Okay. Low risk of injury. Well, if it's low risk, then it's not going to be high reward. Let's see. Land overhead. Overhands. Okay, so the overarching hits. Yeah. All right. Okay. More move evolution boost. Okay. Let's do this.
A few moments later.
Invite a fighter. Should I try learning a new move? Let's promote the fight. I need more people to know about me. Promotions can increase your popularity and build fight hype. Signing a sponsorship will give you more promotional opportunities. Improving connections with other fighters will reduce the cost of learning new moves through invite a fighter. Okay. Okay, so I can't do sponsorships or connections. I'm not that popular yet. Add fight hype to your upcoming fight by selecting available promotions. One mandatory promotions remaining. All right. All right, so we got a local radio interview. Okay. That's risky. Local radio interview. A local sports radio wants to interview you for your upcoming UFC. Post to social media. Get your fans hyped for your upcoming fight. Popularity, fight hype. Okay. Interesting. So I want to increase not only my fight hype, but my popularity in general. So can I do this like 5 times instead? Well, let me just post. Yeah, let's go. Takuya, I love that. That's cool. Can I do it again? Okay. Let's do a radio interview. Let's get my fight hype ready. Okay. Is that my next guy? Okay. Okay. Okay, okay. So there's week one down. Still not a lot of hype. I'll be listening to the interview. Nice job. Okay. Interesting. Alright, let's see what this guy's about. And then your opponent's overall skill level, fighter style, top moves, attributes, tendencies. Okay. So Dawn Charles. Okay, so that wasn't the guy. Overall. Oh, whoa, he's low. Yo, he real low. What's my overall? Bro, I'm 2.5 stars overall. This guy at here with like half star. Like, bro, come on. Though I gotta get in shape for my upcoming fights, so. Okay. Let's do some Muay Thai.
I wanna see you kill it today. Let's go in there.
All right.
And crush this.
Okay. Hold on. Hold on. I need to read. Throw body strikes while employees. Okay.
Nice strike. Right. That'll keep him honest.
Yeah, yeah. Come on, this is easy. Come on, come on. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Spice, spice.
Keep grinding. Keep pushing.
Yeah.
Your next opponent is going to be no match for you.
All right. Still very low fight hype. I need more people to see me win. Yeah, I can't do that. I don't have enough energy. He's that with it. If he's that low, I am really not concerned about him. Like, bruh is a half star. It's like you don't have a chance against me, bro. Stand up. Oh, can I not do it multiple times? Dang. Okay. I guess I'm watching a tape. Fighter style. Kickboxer? Yo, this is in the bag. If he's that and he's a kickboxer just like me, in the bag. Alright, next week. Yeah. Yo, this playlist, though. I might get copyright claim, but... You know, I'm not at that point where I'm too concerned about that, but hey, hey, yo, this is great. definitely need more hype. Yeah. Good. I can't do a radio show anymore, unfortunately. All right. Bro, this song though. Alright, I don't need to watch the tape. Let's invite a fighter and then do some sparring. This relationship meter. All fighters inside an invited fighter have a relationship with you. The better the relationship, the less cash you need to learn a move. The worse the relationship, the more the move costs. Okay. Okay. Khabib, my guy. Kicks. Body spinning sidekick. We got the lead sidekick. Okay. Lead sidekick again. What? What is different? Okay. Okay. Let me see here. So I like the sound of spinning sidekick. So let's go with this.
All right. I want to see you kill it today. Let's go and crush this.
Oh, okay. Back away from me. Okay, so this is a good move for keeping him away.
I can't believe you've done this.
Oh, but boy, can it be punished. Oh, sorry, boy. Come on, do something. Do something. Oh. Let's go. Easy.
Because repetition is the mother of all skill. That's why.
Alright, so simulating a training week can differ depending on the amount of weekly points you have left. If you have 85 or more weekly points remaining in the week, simulating will reward you with some fitness evolution points, but no move evolution. If you have less than 85 weekly points remaining for the week, the option to simulate is still available, but you will not gain any fitness or evolution points, and you are at risk of having an injury. What? What? How is there a risk of injury? I can't... What? I can't do anything. I can't unlock that. And I can't promote myself. Bro, that makes no sense. I want to use all my stuff. Okay. It seems like I don't have a choice. Unless I'm missing something, but that's 50. So, I guess I'm simulating. I'm not injured, am I? No? Good. Alright. What should I work on next? Leg chokes, huh? Submitting clinch transitions, huh? Escape clinch. Damage with knees to body. Superman punches? Bro, I don't think I have Superman punches. I wish. Muay Thai. Go on, folks. Let's put a little bit into wrestling.
Speed and power.
All right, come here. Easy.
Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you.
Okay, so I got 60. So I can spar, and then if I can do a social media post, that'll leave me with 10. I don't have to worry about getting an injury. All right. So what does this do? 5-4. Okay. Use that ultimate to get your fitness to an optimum level with little risk of injury. Move evolution for strikes is reduced by 60%. I like the sound of this. Let's do this.
I'll call it out. You throw.
Come on. Yeah. Easy.
Man,
easy money, easy
next
money.
Opponent is gonna be no match for you.
All right. 10 left, just like I expected. All right, Taku, here's the deal for Dana Wyatt's Contender Series. Get a first round KO or submission, or guaranteed a UFC contract. Anything else, and it depends on what they think of your performances up to now. Let's make it easy for him and end it early. What do you say? Yeah, you read my mind, coach. We ain't getting paid extra to go 3 rounds. I'm aiming for a finish. That's why I upgraded my freaking power and speed, man. All right, here we go. I'm a young man. I'm slightly smaller. Got less weight. All right. Could have sworn I made this guy 140 in like 5'7", but I guess that changed. Are we not allowed to do like respect tests? All right. How about this one? Hey, my man. Yeah. Let's go, boy. Let's go. Come on, come on. I know what I want. I know what I want. Oh, that's not it. That's not it. That works too. Bro, I love forgetting how to do the clinch.
Ooh! Ooh!
Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on, keep your head up, boy. Come on, come on. Let's go, let's go. Let's go. Woo! 2 minutes in, boy. That's how you do it. Let's go, my man, my man. Wham! Bro, that counter, that's insane. Bye, bye. Woo! So you see the ref's animation kick in. He's like, oh wait, I gotta go. That's funny. That's great. I wonder if I can knock their mouth guards out like that. Do I not acquire my nickname yet, bro? Woo! Hey, there's actually medium hype for that fight. Hey, that's good, that's good. Won the fight, finished the opponent. Yeah. All right. All right, that was a quick fight. And we learned a lot. Went through all this training week stuff. I'll probably try to cut this down to make it go a lot faster to get right to the fight. But man, I'm having a great time playing this game. It seems a lot more well-designed compared to the past UFC games. The training feels more precise, like, and more fun. Because like I can pick what I want to train on specifically. Because I think it was UFC 3, or maybe I'm thinking of like the original UFC. And you had to like go into a sparring match, and like you had other like weird mini games to do, but I'd always pick sparring because it was the most fun and like it was the best practice. So I'm glad that they just kept that and had you practice different stuff for the sparring, but that was fun. So if you enjoyed, please consider leaving a like and subscribing. I'll be playing UFC until my career is over or until I get bored with the game. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.